it's me, Courtney, and welcome to my channel. Alright, so today we are talking about the new Kat Von D True Portrait Foundation. I am a huge fan of the original Locket Foundation. It's one of my favorite full coverage foundations of like all time. It's literally like holy grail for me. That's one of the foundations I will continue to purchase. That being said, when this foundation came out, I was really, really curious about it. One, because it said it was like a liquid to powder formula, and I thought that was really, really interesting. But also because it's supposed to be lightweight. Now, the thing about the original Locket Foundation, for me at least, I do feel like it can be heavy for some people, but for me, I thought it was really comfortable. So I was interested to see how this compared and contrasted between the two. So if you're interested in my thoughts, the wear test, wear time, application, all that good stuff, then please continue to watch. All right, so the foundation is $36 for 1 ounce. It comes in 40 shades. I ended up kind of playing around with three different shades. I'm gonna leave pictures as I talk so you guys know what the color looks like. But the first time that I tried it, I got tan 074. It was a little bit too deep for my skin tone. I'm so used to going online and sort of zeroing in on a certain section in foundations just because that's usually the realm that I'm in. But in this case, the tan 074 was a little bit too deep. It was workable if I only wanted to do one layer, but layering it on twice or even three times made it even deeper. So I wanted to get something that was a little bit more versatile. So I ended up going to the store. I was looking for a tan 068, but my store only had tan 066. Unfortunately, that one is a little bit more on the neutral side, which I knew that. I thought that maybe because there was a little bit more warmth in it, even though it was a neutral shade, that I could get away with it, which is, I mean, it was workable, but there was always, every time I wore it, there was just something that was off about it to me. So I went and got tan 068. I had to drive a little bit further out, but I did pick that one up. And that is the one that I'm wearing today. That's the one that I'm gonna go ahead and stick with. So if you are within like my realm, same foundation shade, warm undertone, the tan 068 works the best for me. And if I wanna layer it, it is still layerable without being too deep. I don't remember if I mentioned it in the demo portion, but I do wanna tell you, make sure you guys shake this really, really well. The first time I went in store and swatched this, I didn't think to shake it. I put a little bit on my hand and it was mostly oil that came out. So make sure you shake it up really, really well. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get into the demo portion of the video so you guys can see how the makeup applies. I don't know if y'all can see that up close, but the packaging is actually really, really nice. The only thing about it is because it's white, it gets dirty easy, but I do like the way that it looks. I'm going to do a little bit on my hand. As you can see, it's a really, really watery texture. I'm gonna take my brush. This is one of the Love is a Foundation brushes, the more recent one that I got from Ulta. I actually like the way this foundation looks with a brush over a sponge. Okay, so real quick, I just want to show you, this is no foundation. And with foundation, even though it does say it's a medium coverage, I feel like it gives a pretty almost full coverage kind of look. Granted, you can still see a little bit of my moles, but I feel like it does a way better coverage than just medium. And as you can see, it spreads really, really easily. Alright, so this is what we're looking like with one full layer. It's a very, very light, soft, matte kind of situation. It's very, very lightweight, which I really, really love that about this foundation. It is still slightly tacky. It does dry down completely. The only reason I think that it has a little bit more shine coming through is because I do have my skincare on under this. I am going without like a basic primer today. Now, with that being said, I have used it with, you know, the Locket primer, which is more of a hydrating primer. I have used it with my Tatcha Silk Canvas. Every primer that I've used it with, it does pretty well. I think it's done the best with the what was it, the Tarte Timeless Pore Refining Primer, I think is what it's called, something like that. I think it looked the best with that one. But it goes with any of my primers really well. I'm gonna go ahead and finish the rest of my face and we can come back and I'll let you guys see like the full-on beat. Alright, so this is the bulk of what we're gonna be doing today. I did want to show you guys real quick how I'm gonna set it. I am gonna take a powder. This one's a L'Oreal True Match powder. You can take any face powder that you guys like. I'm just using this one today because it's something that I need to get rid of because I've had it for so long. But I'm gonna take my Laura Mercier powder puff. I'm gonna tap into it. and then dust off any excess on my hand, and then I'm just going to lightly pat that in everywhere. Technically, this foundation does dry down, but again, because it's over my skincare, it still is a little bit tacky. So I'm just gonna take this powder puff and sort of set all of those sticky areas, and now we're completely matte. Now I'm gonna take the Kat Von D Lock It Setting Mist. It is now 11:38. I think I'm gonna give this one a 8-hour wear test and see what we're looking like towards the end of the day. By the way, everything on my face will be listed in the description box below. The eye look specifically is going to be in a video coming up shortly within the next like week or two. So, you know, stay tuned for that if you're interested. In the meantime, I'm gonna go ahead and get out of here and show you guys what it looks like at the end of the day. All right guys, I am back and this is what my face is looking like. Ignore this situation right here because I definitely was like blowing my nose and, you know, being real ladylike today. Aside from that, I am a little bit shiny. I am noticing some creasing right here. Every other time that I've worn this foundation, I have not gotten creasing. But today, again, I didn't wear a primer at all. But yeah, so I do have a slight amount of creasing, not too crazy. By the way, it is 8:09. So we've had this foundation on for about 8 hours and some change. One of the first claims that it said was that it was lightweight, which I definitely agree with. Even with my oils coming through, it still feels very comfortable. Like I don't feel like it's too heavy. I will say though, if you are somebody who's a little bit newer to makeup, it might feel a little bit heavy on you. A lot of times when people wear makeup or foundation all the time, like I do, like I get used to certain feelings of makeup. But if you're somebody who's used to not feeling anything, then you might feel this a little bit. But aside from that, if you're like a regular foundation user, it feels normal. You know what I mean? It doesn't feel too icky. I'm not like scratching my face to get it off, you know what I mean? It also claimed that it was a medium coverage. I actually would venture to say that it's more of a medium to full coverage. So for me, when I think of like a medium coverage foundation, I typically think of like Fenty's foundation, both the Pro Filter matte one and the, what was the one that she just came out with? The Luminous one. It's been a real long day, my apologies. But yeah, so like those are like the Tarte Babassu foundation. Those are more of a medium coverage foundation to me. Like looking at this, I feel like this foundation pretty much in one layer sort of covered up a lot of, you know, imperfections, you know? And if you put two layers on, which I do think it's doable with this foundation, especially because it dries down the way that it does, I feel like you could get a full coverage with this foundation. It said it was a liquid to powder foundation. We kind of talked about that a little bit earlier. Even though it does dry down, as you can see throughout the days, your oils are gonna come through. Honestly, I did not have like a super busy day today. I wasn't like outside in the heat and the elements, which by the way, it's not even hot outside anymore. It's like, what, 60 degrees outside, which is cold for me. I'm happy about it, but also it was just 90 degrees yesterday, so I don't know how I feel. Anyway. But yeah, so it does still get oily, so even though it does go from liquid to powder feeling and it dries down, I don't feel like it stays matte all day. Regardless if you set it or don't set it, you will get your oils peeking through. My oils started coming through with this foundation today at about 3 to 4 o'clock. However, it didn't get any worse when the oils did come out. It's not the kind of foundation that like gets oily and then gets worse and worse and worse throughout the day. It literally got a little oily and then this was it. And honestly, if you're somebody that blots throughout the day or you like to use powder here and there, just do like one quick blot and I think you're gonna be good for the rest of the day. Cause I mean, even looking at this, I like the way that my skin looks. Minus this nonsense right here, but I do like the way that my skin looks. The only thing is, as well, that I did want to mention, it does transfer once it gets oily. It's definitely there. Y'all can't see that. I don't know why I did that. Anyway, it says it's like a airy matte finish and normal combo and oily skin. I actually have dry skin and I wear it and I really, really enjoy it. And I think most people can wear this foundation. I don't really think it's that polarizing for normal oily skin types, if that makes sense. I think dry skin can definitely wear this. Even if you have severely dry skin, I would just sort of play with different primers to see which primers work the best for you. I played with this on a number of levels and I like the foundation with different things. If I'm comparing it to the Lack It foundation, I know a lot of people had problems with like blending out the Lack It foundation. It is one of those stick and move kind of foundations. For me, I never had any trouble with that, which is kind of weird, but I never had trouble blending it out. For me, it always laid really nicely on my skin and I never felt like it was too mattifying or too drying, and it was a really, really good full coverage foundation. That being said, if I'm comparing the two, I feel like this one definitely feels more, the word that they use was like airy, and I do get that vibe from it a little bit. I feel like both of them are comfortable on me, if that makes sense. And I feel like you can get a full coverage with this one as well. If you are somebody that maybe didn't like the Lock It foundation, this might be your new jam. Just because I feel like you can get a similar vibe from this foundation, but it feels more lightweight, it feels more just airy. Airy is the right word for that. Although I will say I have less transfer with the Lock It foundation than with this one, if we're comparing. Even when the Lock It foundation gets oily, which it really doesn't get that oily on me, but when it gets just slightly oily, it's not like transferring all over the place, all over my clothes kind of thing. Whereas this one, you can definitely like move it. Now granted, it's still in place, it didn't come off, but it does kind of move around. So if you're like hugging your boyfriend or your husband or something like that and he has on a white shirt, other than that, that's really the only cons I have. I actually really like this foundation. It's more unique, I think, than any of the other formulas that I've tried, especially within the realm of foundations that are coming out. And I do recommend this foundation, especially if you want to try a foundation that's a little bit different than what you're used to and what's, you know, out on the market. It is very unique that way. So I am gonna take out the same powder that I used earlier. I'm gonna lightly set it again, just so you guys can see what the blotting will do for it. And see, all right, so went ahead and added some powder, and to me it looks good all over again, and it's set all over again, so it's not oily again. Yay, I really like this foundation, I really do. All right guys, that about does it for me. Hopefully this video was helpful, especially if you're curious about this Kat Von D foundation. If it did help you guys out, please give me a thumbs up. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Share the video if the mood suits you. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.